Hello and welcome to Meshta. In our previous video, we have discussed about what is design thinking and importance of design thinking. And in this video, we will discuss about how can we make our product sustainable. Before starting this video, I want to give you a little disclaimer that in this video, we will go through various definitions and example. So I will suggest you to write down those definitions or you can also take the screenshots. So without any further ado, let's get started. When looking for sustainable material, the first step is to know where the ecological impact comes from. Here are some guidelines. First, abundant material are usually more sustainable than scarce material. For example, in 1920, we need to dig 4 kg of ore in order to get 1 kg of copper. But now, we need to dig 100 kg of ore to get the same amount of copper, and the rest 99 kg get into the waste. And this data keeps changing. The second guideline is use those material which have less embodied energy. Now, what do I mean by embodied energy? As the name suggests, embodied energy is the energy that must be used to extract, transport, and process the material. Usually, material carbon footprint is directly proportional to embodied energy. Now, what do I mean by carbon footprint? The amount of carbon dioxide released into the atmosphere as a result of activities is known as carbon footprint. So, if we use any material which has high embodied energy, then it will also release more carbon dioxide. And as we know that carbon dioxide is harmful for our environment, and according to the definition of sustainable design simply means environmental conscious design. A great way to reduce embodied energy is to specify recycled material for your design. For example, using recycled aluminium can cut embodied energy by 90%. And if you are using recyclable material, you will also want to design your product to ensure those material can be recovered at the product's end of life. But some material also have negative health impact. For example, lead, and some material that are not harmful can require toxins to manufacture. For example, extracting gold from an ore usually requires cyanide, and as we know that cyanide is a toxin. Here I have used a word toxin. Toxin simply means hazardous substance. So whenever possible, avoid hazard substances, and if you can't completely eliminate them, clearly label toxins and use suppliers with high safety standards. But product is not sustainable if its physical properties are not up to the task it is designed for. For an example, let us suppose that I want to make a coffee cup and I choose newspaper as the material for our coffee cup. So as we know that newspaper is abundant and it can be recycled, it is cheap and it has low embodied energy. But I can't use newspaper because if I pour coffee into the newspaper cup, then our product fails. And that exactly what we will look at next. So up to then, stay safe and stay tuned. Thank you.